Norbert of Xanten was born circa 1075 and died in 1134. Muslim and Christians drawing each other's blood. A reform papacy calling rulers and hierarchs, clergy and monks, to renewal. Lay men and women hungry for a renewed preaching of the gospel. The poor and disenfranchised, often ground down by regional power brokers. Around the year 1075, into this world, a world not unlike our own, was born Norbert of Xanten, second son of the Count of Genep. Young Norbert, raised on the border between today's Netherlands and Germany, was neither a prodigal son nor a fervent Christian. Like many young nobles of his time, he had found his way as an opportunistic cleric. A courtier caught in the struggle between church and state powers, he was looking to advance his career in the entourage of the powerful Archbishop of Cologne and the court of the German Emperor. That was all to change. One day in 1115, Norbert was riding on the road to Freyden. He was struck down, stunned, and awoken by a heavenly voice, urging him to turn from sin and seek after peace. And so he did. Norbert pursued the ordination to the priesthood, an act of commitment that he seems to have been putting off for decades. And for a period of 3 years, he went from one renewal center and spiritual leader to another. On his way, he sought out warring lords in order to reconcile their opposing causes. Not surprisingly, Norbert ran afoul of fellow clergy and bishops. So, Norbert sought out the Pope, gaining his approval of his ministry. Eventually, a new Pope commended Norbert to the care of the Bishop of Lyon in France, who helped Norbert find an abandoned forest chapel at a place named Prémontré. At Prémontré, Norbert gathered his many men and women followers. During Midnight Mass, Christmas, 1121, the core group of ordained ministers serving this village of reform made profession of vows. They promised to live the apostolic life of the early Jerusalem community according to the rule of St. Augustine. But Norbert was not a stay-at-home kind of preacher. He continued to travel and preach and establish new centers of reform, the first abbeys of what would become a major reform order. In 1126, Norbert was chosen Archbishop of Magdeburg, Germany, a center of missionary evangelization focused on Central and Eastern Europe. From Magdeburg, the new order spread. Norbert became once again an advocate for peace in the struggles between church and state. Following an arduous journey accompanying the emperor to Rome, Norbert died at Magdeburg in 1134. Some 500 years later, in 1626, the saint's body was taken from its resting place in Magdeburg and moved in solemn procession to the Norbertine Abbey of Strahov in Prague, where it rests to this day. The 900-year-old Norbertine order, once several hundred houses strong, declined under the impact of historical forces. The Reformation, Henry VIII's dissolution of the monasteries in England, the French Revolution, the secularization of the Spanish communities, all took their toll on the order. Beginning in the mid-19th century, though, the order rose from its ashes. The Norbertines now number 1,300 men and women religious in 90 or more communities. They serve today on 5 continents, living out through diverse ministries the values handed down through the ages from their founding saint.